You mentioned that a big shift happened from offline to real time.
Yeah. So there was that was good. But there are some consequences that result from having access to real time. And one of the consequences is you don't have to know so much because you just push buttons and turn knobs and you turn things, make noises until your ear says, okay, I like that. The value in the early days of not having real time is we had to know a lot more about what we would expect from trying to make a 2-second example, say a discovery of FM. Discovery, not invention, because it's a gift of nature, FM, and Bessel functions and all that go into it. But to make a small test, 2 seconds of sound, I would have to wait sometimes 10 minutes. If there were lots of users on the timeshare machine, maybe an hour to do 2 seconds of music. But all the time, I'm thinking, and I'm trying to understand what will I hear. So we learned about psychoacoustics and perception because the cost of computing was so great. We had to inform ourselves to enrich the possible result. So there was a lot of work in perception. Real time, people just work. There's no longer the requirement for understanding to the extent that we had to. And it makes real-time music very rich, of course. And there are some people who are not tempted always just to work in real time.